Ladies and gentlemen,
many of the Kosovo Albanians, they don't want to see the Russian troops in their communities.
I think the people of these communities should be very confident that the Russian forces are part of KFOR. They're following the same operations plan. They're following the same rules of engagement. Many of them will be working side by side with other KFOR forces. They'll all be embedded in headquarters with liaison and other communications. And I think there's to be no problem on this. I understand the some of the historic and some of the recent circumstances. I've heard a lot of these concerns. We're very sensitive to them. But all of us are committed, and the Russian forces are committed, to working together and to do our very best to implement the military technical annex and to support the overall international community mission here in Kosovo.
One of the objections by local citizens are accusations that Russians fought cyber.
They're very competent. They're very professional. They're made up of a lot of young people. It's their first time abroad. I've met many of their soldiers in Bosnia. I've been very impressed with them. So I would ask the people of Kosovo to be very understanding of this. And remember, these Russian forces are here at the invitation of the international community, as all the other forces are, to do their job for the people of Kosovo, for all the people of Kosovo.
Characterize that compliance, please, and could you tell us if you think they will meet their 30-day?
The UCK will hand over the weapons to KFOR.
Komandanti KFOR-it i ka dhënë përgjegjësisë gjithë anësive të KFOR-it në terren, të cilat duhet të kryejnë detyrat, ajo është detyrë komandanti KFOR-it.
And it's the duty of the task of commander of KFOR to distribute the tasks to its own units.
I think that's good.
Thank you very much. We'll cut it off here. Thank you.